place. Tell me if you need more room. He says, since this tripod is sitting behind me.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
And a very Merry Christmas to you all. I'm tired of saying that, that's all right. Because we still have several more days of Christmas to go. I know the culture is done with it, and we're already on to Valentine's Day. But in church, we're not. So we are going to suck every ounce of good Christmas juju out of this season that we can by singing all the wonderful carols that we know that are going to warm our hearts with gladness and make us remember the wonderful birth of Jesus and the saving acts that it accomplished in music and in reading today. The service of lessons and carols was originally brought to us in 1918 by an army chaplain. As you can read in your bulletin, some of the history behind the first service at King's College in Cambridge. This year, our music director, Jim Douglas, thought it'd be a good idea and a neat thing to recreate that service today, and I'm thrilled with what he's come up with. So I know that you'll join us in singing and reflecting on the readings that we have today. And again, I thank you very much for being here at St. Margaret's this morning. Thank you.
Thank you.
Christ. Be it this Christmas season our care and delight to prepare ourselves to hear again the message of the angels, in heart and mind, to go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, and the babe lying in a manger. Let us read and mark in Holy Scripture the tale of the loving purposes of God from the first days of our disobedience unto the glorious redemption brought us by this holy child. And let us make this sanctuary dedicated to Mary, his most blessed mother, glad with our carols of praise. But first let us pray for the needs of his whole world, for the peace and goodwill over all the earth, for unity and brotherhood within the church God came to build. And because of this, of all things, would rejoice God's heart. Let us at this time remember in Christ's name the poor and the helpless, the cold, the hungry and the oppressed, the immigrant, the sick in body and in mind, and them that mourn, the lonely and the unloved, the aged and the little children, all who know not the Lord Jesus, or who love him not, or who by sin have grieved his heart with love. Lastly, let us remember before God all those who rejoice with us, but upon another shore and in a greater light, that multitude which no man can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, and with whom, in this Lord Jesus, we forevermore are one. These prayers and praises let us humbly offer up to the throne of heaven, in the words which Christ himself hath taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Almighty God, bless us with his grace. Christ, give us the joys of everlasting life. And unto the fellowship of the citizens above, may the King of Angels bring us all.
Amen.
Gave us to be with me. She gave me the tree, and I did eat. And the Lord Lord God said unto the woman, What is it that thou hast done? And the woman said, The serpent beguiled me, and I did eat. And the Lord God said unto the serpent, Because thou hast done this, thou art cursed above all cattle, and above every beast of the field. Upon thy belly shalt thou go, and dust shalt thou eat all the days of thy life. And I will put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed. It shall bruise thy head, and thou shalt bruise his heel. And unto Adam he said, Because thou hast hearkened unto the voice of thy wife, and hast eaten of the tree of which I commanded thee, saying, Thou shalt not eat of it. Cursed is the ground for thy sake. In sorrow shalt thou eat of it all the days of thy life. Thorns also and thistles shall it bring forth to thee, and thou shalt eat the herb of the field. The sweat of thy face shalt thou eat bread, till thou return unto the ground. For out of it wast thou taken, for dust thou art, and to dust shalt thou return. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God promises to faithful Abraham that in his seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed. The Lord God took the man and put him in the Garden of Eden to till it and keep it. And the Lord God commanded the man, You may freely eat of every tree of the garden, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil you shall not eat, for in the day that you eat of it you shall die. Then the Lord God said, It is not good that the man should be alone. I will make him a helper as his partner. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. prophet foretells the coming of the Savior. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness, from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Christ will bring is foreshown. But you, O Bethlehem of Ephrathah, who are one of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient days. Therefore he shall give them up until the time when she who is in labor has brought forth. Then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall live secure, for now he shall be great to the ends of the earth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
What sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her,
Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor, David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end. Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave the power to become children of God, who were born not of blood or of the will of the flesh or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The genealogy of Jesus the Messiah. An account of the genealogy of Jesus the Messiah, the son of David, the son of Abraham. Abraham was the father of Isaac, and Isaac the father of Jacob, and Jacob the father of Judah and his brothers, and Judah the father of Perez and Zerah by Tamar, and Perez the father of Hezron, and Hezron the father of Aram, and Aram the father of Amminadab, and Amminadab the father of Nashon, and Nashon the father of Salmon, and Salmon the father of Boaz by Rahab, and Boaz the father of Obed by Ruth, and Obed the father of Jesse, and Jesse father. wife of Uriah, and Solomon the father of Rehoboam, and Rehoboam the father of Abijah, and Abijah the father of Asaph, and Asaph the father of Jehoshaphat, and Jehoshaphat the father of Joram, and Joram the father of Uzziah, and Uzziah the father of Jotham, and Jotham the father of Ahaz, and Ahaz the father of Hezekiah, and Hezekiah the father of Manasseh, and Manasseh the father of Amos, and Amos the father of Josiah, and Josiah the father of Jeconiah and his brothers, at the time of the deportation to Babylon. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
explains the redemptive power of Jesus' birth. But when the fullness of time had come, God sent his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, in order to redeem those who were under the law, so that we might receive adoption as children. And because you are children, God has sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, crying, Abba, Father. So you are no longer a slave, but a child. And if a child, then also an heir through God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Visiting, please come back and you'll see a different liturgy Obviously, this is the one time of the year that we do this Lessons and Carols liturgy, but come back and you'll see us. You'll see the same kind of great liturgy. I also want to mention that in the back of the church, on the marble table back there, is a lovely manger scene, a creche scene, that was donated in memory of Roy Haw by his wife Anne and his daughter Judith, that Judith brought in last Sunday. And when you see it, I'd like you to remember Roy. Christmas was a special time for him. And remember him, remember his family. And now he is with that heavenly band of choir in heaven, right at the manger. So know that he's there, and we thank you for that, Judith. And now, ascribe to the Lord the honor due God's name. Bring offerings and come into God's courts. Christ, you offer peace, justice, and grace to all people. In response to your great gifts, we offer these tithes. Bless these gifts that we offer and use them for the work of your kingdom on earth. In your name we pray.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Also with you.
Let us pray. O Lord, who makest us glad with the yearly remembrance of the birth of thy only Son, Jesus Christ, grant that as we joyfully receive him for our Redeemer, so we may with sure confidence behold him when he shall come to be our Judge, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end.
Amen.
Thank you. clear people out, knock them in the head with the Advent wreath.